Cancer is made of cells, just like anything. A cancerous tumor is simply a collection of cells that are rebelling. There are trillions of cells in the human body. Estimates range from about 15 to 70 trillion. It's kind of hard to say for sure. All these cells are making copies of themselves, constantly replicating and copying their own DNA all the time. And as much as we want it to be, nothing is perfect. Sometimes they just naturally rebel and become cancerous. Let's break this down so we're all on the same page. Different cells replicate at different rates. A red blood cell lives about 4 months, a skin cell a few weeks, and cells in the colon only live a few days. By the time you're 50, you've gone through about 4,600 generations of colon cells. That's insane. By the time you're 70, you've almost had 6,500 new colons. Many millions of cells in the colon dividing 6,500 times. It's no wonder that tiny errors would pop up here and there. And that's how cells become abnormal. Most of the time, in talk about avoiding cancer, you're gonna hear things like, don't eat processed meat, it's a carcinogen. Don't smoke, the crap in the cigarettes will give you lung cancer. Stay out of the sun, because UV light is gonna give you skin cancer. All that is true. But all those cancers do happen for the same reason. Simply put, compounds in the smoke, or meat from the processing, or UV radiation from the sun mess with DNA in your cells. When your DNA is screwed with, it can sometimes mutate in such a way that it becomes cancerous. And this can happen even without outside influences. Mutations happen naturally. So, 2 years ago, a paper was published that said most cancers in the United States weren't caused by smoking, UV exposure, or lifestyle factors, but by regular old DNA replication. Sometimes cancer just happens. The paper says that while 40% of cancers can be prevented with healthy lifestyle choices, the remainder of cancer causes were inherited traits or just dumb luck, just problems in cell replication. Skeptical scientists were quick to jump on this original paper, in part because it was only done in the United States. The lives of people in the US are not the same as people everywhere. It's not easily generalizable to all the humans in the world, right? Right. So the scientists heard the critique and did the whole study again. It took them 2 years. This time they included data from 69 countries. They added more cancer types. They found the same thing. 66% of cancers just happen. And the rest were environmental factors, lifestyle choices, or genetics. For example, while most brain and prostate cancers, as well as cancers in children, are caused by DNA copy errors, some lung cancers are mostly due to environmental factors. So don't smoke. But also yikes for kids. It's probably not a surprise, but many doctors are not happy with this paper. How can we cure cancer if cancer is a normal part of a healthy DNA replication cycle? I mean, you can still cut your risk by nearly half by living healthily, but overall, cancer may just be inevitable for some. This is why we need to focus on understanding cancer on top of the talk of curing cancer. You can cure cancer as a symptom, but you can't cure cancer, the mutation, without a lot more science. If we just think of cancer as this infection that happens to people who don't live right, who are unlucky or something else, then we're ignoring the pure mathematics of DNA replication. We're not being honest with ourselves. Cancer sucks, but it's also a normal part of life on this planet. And just like anything else, the sooner we accept it and understand it, the better off we'll all be at figuring out how we can just live. Special thanks to our sponsor, domain.com. When you buy a domain name from domain.com, you're taking the first steps in creating an identity and vision for your brand. No domain extension will help you tell your story like a .com or .net domain name. Get 15% off domain.com's already affordable domain names and web hosting when you use the coupon code SEEKER at checkout. If cancer is just cells and lots of animals get cancer, I wonder if I've ever eaten cancer. Ever thought about that? That's kind of gross. Also, in the realm of gross things I've never thought about, our producer Matt asked, what does human flesh taste like and which bit of it is most nutritious? Find out here. Please subscribe. Thanks for watching. We'll see you later.